Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. The NASA spacecraft Voyager 1 has provided scientists on Earth with a series of theory-shattering surprises. The probes Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 are now exploring the outer boundary of the Sun's domain, called the heliosphere. What the probes have encountered was not what astronomers expected. Through a series of surprises, astronomers have openly expressed their complete bafflement over the Voyager data. In a recent Wired.com piece, the lead author of a paper in the journal Science states, "The models that have been thought to predict what should happen are all incorrect. We essentially have absolutely no reliable roadmap of what to expect at this point." Let us begin by addressing the predictions of the standard model of the heliospheric boundary and how that model compares to the predictions of the Electric Universe.
Well, there's two things. One is it's regarded by physicists as being purely a mechanical shock effect, you know, like a boat plowing through water or an aircraft going supersonic. The theory that's applied to the behavior of the magnetic field at the boundary relies on magnetohydrodynamics, which Alfvén pointed out is an invalid theory to use for plasma in space. You know, one of the problems they've struck is that the magnetic field didn't change direction when they felt they may have left the heliosphere. And according to the shock front theory, of course, the magnetic field will be diverted around to follow the shock. Instead of that, it just continued on. Now, there's also a bland expectation that the magnetic field spirals out simply because of the rotation of the Sun. But when you consider that the Sun is a tiny speck, like the size of a pencil point, the heliosphere is about 20 feet in diameter. And they're saying that this tiny little rotating speck of dust is causing this magnetic field to spiral out. What they haven't considered is that that spiral is the same kind of spiral currents you see in spiral galaxies, and that therefore the effect is being driven from outside the heliosphere and not from within. There's also the other aspect of the boundary, and that is the unexpected slowdown of the solar wind before they reach this so-called boundary, the change in the nature of the energetic particles at that boundary. Now, all of these things can have an explanation, a simple explanation, in terms of plasma sheaths, which imply an electric current flowing between the galaxy and our Sun. And this, of course, is part of that's the basis of the electrical model of the powering of the Sun. So the evidence that they're discovering at this boundary with the interstellar space is all indicative of electrical interactions at that boundary, which is exactly what was expected.
NASA's IBEX mission shed new and astounding light on the outer heliosphere when it discovered an unexpected ribbon of energetic neutral atoms. Principal investigator David McComas states, "The thing that's really shocking is this ribbon. Our previous ideas about the outer heliosphere are going to have to be revised."
When the IBEX mission was proposed, I wrote 2 years before the spacecraft was launched that on the basis of these ideas, standard expectations of a kind of cometary interface with the interstellar medium would not be met. And of course, when the IBEX mission finally began to return information from beyond the heliosphere, in other words, our actual interaction region with interstellar space, yeah, they were completely blown away. It was completely unexpected. Under the electrical model, the Sun occupies interstellar space, which has a magnetic field. That magnetic field is indicative of an electric current flowing within our region in the galaxy. And it also gives the direction of that electric current flowing past the Sun. Mm-hmm. And it's quite different from the mechanical direction of the Sun. If you looked at the Sun as being a boat plowing through water, the material that is being shed by the Sun in the form of the solar wind should, when it meets this oncoming flow from the galaxy, be diverted and flow back around it, just like the wake of a boat. But this is what was found. My view was that we only had to look at nearby stars and even distant supernovae, those which have lit up their environment. And the best example of that is the planetary nebulae with their hourglass shape. And this was the kind of interface that I was expecting. And, of course, the hourglass shape has a neck, a narrow neck. And at that neck, when you look at supernovae explosions, in particular supernova 1987A, that classic one which has the ring of beads around its equatorial region, I expected that kind of interface. And that was precisely what the ENA, the energetic neutral atom results from the IBEX mission showed. And also the fact that they changed rapidly in over a period of weeks or months, which shows that the region is fairly thin. This is totally unexpected and unexplained by any standard model. But this is the kind of thing you expect from Birkeland currents, which are thin filaments of current. And it depends also on the material that's flowing through them, whether it lights up and gives these bright beads that were found around the solar system, and their variation in time. The other thing that surprised the researchers was the breadth that they covered, these glowing regions that were returning the energetic neutral atoms. This is not expected on the basis of the solar wind interacting with something out there, but it is expected electrically. So it was a huge confirmation of the electrical model of the sun at its outer boundaries.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.